July has brought an average amount of rain to the Dustups Ranch. Hallelujah. But that does not mean the drought is over. We have improved from the worst drought category of exceptional all the way to extreme drought, which sounds funny to say, but I'm really glad that we're making progress towards rehydrating the ranch. I've been lingering in the past few episodes on these rain events because they represent everything that we've worked so hard to build. And look at all this water. Yes, the water's here and we rejoice in the abundance. The reason we do all of this is that we know hard times are coming. In fact, they're still here. But it's good to pause and enjoy the results that have been accomplished, and then to think about how we can make the system even better. Getting much closer to camp, and I can see the stakes that I've laid out, but I haven't got to run the dozer. And this is the part where I stopped working, so I'm hoping that the swale caught some flow, but it might have to be extended to really get it. You can see the hydrogel that I laid out in preparation for extending the terrace. I would want to get this buried as fast as possible, but I would compress everything so badly. Look at this. A new swale already doing its job. Okay, I'm gonna walk on the inner lip. And I knew this was gonna happen because I didn't, I wasn't done, still not done. But this inner lip is where the trees are gonna go. And I'm gonna walk as far away from them as possible so I don't compact what I'm working so hard to do. Yes, look at that lake up there. Yes, 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 yes. Oh boy. Look at all this water, y'all. Yeah. Look at all that water. This is the point. And looks like not even fully graded. Oh boy. Look at that, and this is all clay, guys. This is just gonna be super slick for probably a week. And that's the plan, is just trees and grass all right in here. And if I was done with the grading, I would put the seeds down, but I'm so happy it works. Look at that. All that water flowed down here. Looks like the rough grading is correct. And this is a little off because I can see the water flowing a little bit the wrong way. And let's see if we gave up any water. Whoa! The hole is full of water. That's 3 feet deep.
Thanks to Fabletics for sponsoring today's episode. Whether I'm going to a business meeting in downtown Fort Worth, or I'm working on my centropic agroforestry system here in my backyard, I need gear that shows up for both, and that is why I wear Fabletics. One of the key things I do to manage my day is I try to minimize the amount of decisions I make, and by being a VIP member of Fabletics, I have great looking clothes and the outfits are chosen for me because I don't want to put any effort into looking good. I like the benefits of both, where I look good and I don't spend any mental energy going through my wardrobe trying to figure out what I'm going to wear. Being able to grab an outfit and just look good and go, that's a double win. I look sharp and I don't even have to think about it. Head over to fabletics.com/dustups and sign up as a VIP member. You'll get 80% off of your first month. Simplify your mornings while looking good, while you upgrade your style. Sponsors like Fabletics are what makes Dustups possible. Without the sponsor support and ultimately your support of my sponsors, I can't do the desert forest. I really appreciate your serious consideration of Fabletics and all of my sponsors. Make sure you check out the link in the description. And now, back to the episode.
I don't think we lost any water, guys. Like, I think the swales caught almost all of it and didn't have to give up hardly any. Can you imagine? I'm only about an eighth done. And if I, woulda, coulda, shoulda. Really wish I had that plan earlier, but it's on pause until that dries out a little bit and we can not ruin our work.
Next week, I'm gonna show you why I'm extending this plan.
Just kidding, let's do that now. I have a project in Google Earth where I've marked the earthworks designs. The swale featured in this episode is Camp Swale 3, which we're working hard to extend all the way to the property line. Two more swales will go above it on this 11-acre hillside, catching every possible drop of water and dropping it into a single location right here by camp. This map is available inside of Team Dustups at the Agave Ally level, the second tier. You get immediate access to the map and all sorts of behind-the-scenes images and videos that won't ever make it on the channel. Scan the QR code or click the link in the description. That'll get you access to Team Dustups right now. And based on the footage that Daniel shared, I'm adding a second source of water for these infiltration ponds that'll fill Dove Alley. We're going to divert water out of this canyon for two reasons. It concentrates more water in a single location, and it protects our road that we use to access the canyon system.
You know, I don't know how to explain it. I know you're experiencing it because you're here as well, how alive this desert becomes right after a rain. Like, you know, I've got some footage of active erosion. The frogs coming out, the lizards, these little red bugs, those flying. It's so amazing. There's a little waterfall over there when it rains. It's unbelievable how alive this place becomes when it rains. It's unbelievable. That agave is definitely going to get enough water. So that little bug, this little dude right here, they have popped up everywhere. Not 100% sure what it is. They're all over the place. That's where he was, so, you know, let nature take its course.
All of the water was coming out of these two canyons. And, yeah, I couldn't get but so close.
Yeah.
Because there was active erosion. Like,
even this part, actively eroding as we speak. Kind of want to go down to see what Oxford Canyon looks like right now. I'll see if I can get around to the edge of Oxford Canyon and see what I can see. All right, so to the left is our entrance down into Cottonwood Canyon. That right there is Cottonwood Canyon. It's running enough that you may be able to see it. It is almost like rapids coming out of there. And all that water is funneled through here, which is the rest of Cottonwood, and goes out to Oxford. I'm walking over to Oxford Canyon right now. But again, I'm not getting too close to the edge because of all the erosion that happened earlier. I'm not trying to end up down in the canyon. Surprising. All of that is coming from the ranch. And if you look, got a little waterfall right there.
Daniel didn't have any experience using a laser transit, and as you can imagine, seeing all of that water on a swale that's not even close to finished, that got me all sorts of fired up to get that project going. So I made time to teach Daniel and to work with him to get some of the grading shot. I wanted him to be able to extend the swale all the way to the property line as fast as possible because we are in the middle of monsoon season. I do not want to lose any more water. This is only in my cabin because it needs, this way it's charged the second I need it.
What's that?
The rangefinder.
Oh, okay.
I figure while we've got two people, may as well carry as much stuff as possible because we'll need the stakes.
I think it's going down slower.
Yeah, I mean, especially at the bottom, it really ought to be. I thought it was saturated last time. Now it really ought to be saturated. And what's nice is clay doesn't tend to have water go down. It tends to spread water laterally. So what's nice about that hole being so deep is it's hydrating
the area
at 3 foot depth. So I will say this is a lot easier walking on than compared to the last time. So one thing I regret doing is where the terrain's really uneven when you cut. I wish I would have, like it worked out here because I could see where the stake was, but I really wish I would have added a stake in the middle. You'll see where I'm talking about. See the stake over here. Should talk about how to bulldoze this part.
All right.
You don't have to worry too much about if digging too far, because you'll be on the inside of the lip rather than the outside of the lip. So it's really more just about maintaining like tilted shape. I'm obviously very exaggerating, but
correct.
And you'll kind of ballpark it, but what'll be more effective is you'll want to take material from up here in the in this wash and just shove it down.
Okay.
And just dig.
If you look at each individual little wash, it's like green fingers.
Yeah.
Sticking out.
And that'll change over time as we start building this swale system. They're all going to be sharing the water, so you'll get just way more greenery. This system of swales will be well over a mile long. I haven't calculated it yet, but like just this first run is easily a quarter mile, and then it's going to loop back a quarter mile.
And then back again as it turns around.
Yeah, it goes that way. So
if we multiply the amount of rain times that little bit that you have done already.
Yeah.
That's an astronomical amount of water that we're keeping on the ranch.
Exactly.
Putting it back into the ground.
Exactly. But you can see like this part is going to be super weird.
Oh wow. Yeah.
So this one, it loops over here, and then the next stake is across the valley. This one is like, it's so big that you're gonna have to like take a lot of material from uphill to make it work. Like this spot's gonna take quite a while.
I'm literally gonna have to turn into here.
Exactly. So we'll do this as a practice just to set a stake that's level with this.
Mm-hmm.
And that way you know
how far over I gotta go.
Yeah, how much to bend. So what I'm gonna do is, and I should mention that laser is not good for your eyes. So.
Oh, I'm not planning on looking at it.
Okay. So we'll put this nice and tall. And then I realized using it last time, I was not going aggressive enough on the grade. Just kind of seeing how everything performed and then knowing how much rain came with when Brandon was here. I think I'm gonna set it for a 0.5% grade. Just enough that water flows, but not...
not rushes.
Yeah. So 0.5% grade would be 0.5 foot every 100 feet. We're doing 0.25 foot every 50 feet. That's good. And then it really important, you have to turn the laser off before you move it. It's extremely sensitive.
Oh, I assumed that. Those dino thingies are everywhere over here.
The mites?
Yeah, the red velvet mites.
Oh yeah.
That's all.
I'm at 16.7 right here.
Okay.
But let me confirm with you.
So these 50 yards apart?
Yeah.
Why don't we tie a loop around that, come here and cut it?
That's what we're gonna do. I just wanted to I wanted to be really precise on this measurement. So if you guys stand right at the stake, 15.4. 16.6, right here.
You might want to go from that one to this one.
Just for the line of sight.
Shot and there's no prickly pear in the way to.
Do you mind standing over on the stake? And that way I can make sure that the distance is right.
The next stake?
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Whoop.
Maybe.
You're willing to.
I'm trying to. And I like Ocotillo, so I don't want to like mess it up.
Yeah, it's too short. It's 15.4.
Okay.
If you have ideas for how to make a bigger target, so that it's, well, actually using the string is the best way.
Yeah, that's the simplest, and you can do that by yourself.
Yeah. Let's get it pretty close without tension. I mean, I really should have done this with a tape measure beforehand, but whether it's on a 0.2% grade or a 0.3% grade, I mean, the point is just to make sure that we know which way's down.
Right.
Just slide it under the prickly pear, just under that bush. Yeah,
down here, but
that's good enough to.
We can.
Now we can move the stake once we shoot it. And make sure you lock that aluminum part down so it doesn't shimmy on you.
That was way lower than I thought it was going to be.
Yeah.
Level is dead on. Look how close you were.
That's not skill. Trust me, I can't begin to do that consistently. I should have spent the time coiling it instead of taking a shortcut. This is now gonna bite me. There you go, right there. Just go a little high. That's good. If you know you're high, it's okay.
It's just a little, oh.
There we go. Does this look level-ish to you? Way too low, I think. Yeah.
Oh, wow. That's gonna be up here. I don't know why I got confused with the beeps for a second. Slow beeps, too low, fast beeps, too high.
It took me forever to get it. I wouldn't stress.
How big do you want to make it? Come on.
Whatever size is appropriate. It's not going to be massive. It's a pocket pond is the idea, but honestly, that's a long way from happening.
The swale is actually a little further along than I was able to fit into this episode. We have now finished with what we're calling the rough cut. So it extends all the way to the property line and it's 1,200 feet long. So Daniel and I are going to be pushing very hard to extend not just this existing swale, but to start implementing that plan that I showed you on screen in the middle of the episode.